Hi everyone! Today we're going to be talking about preparing your garden soil for planting vegetables. Now, taking the time to improve the soil fertility is a very important step that will pay dividends down the road with a productive garden that will put food on your table. Now, many people like to grow in raised beds and add purchased soil, which can add up and be quite expensive. Today we're here at Mary Jo's house where she has an existing garden plot. We're going to be preparing and amending her existing soil. Hey Mary Jo!
Hey, how are you?
Good. Look at you already in the garden.
I am trying to get started.
Getting ready.
Yep.
Well, Mary Jo, you've worked really, really hard on growing your seedlings indoors from the $10 garden kit. They're looking really good. I know you're working on hardening them off.
Yep.
To prepare them to plant here in your garden bed.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever you've gotten this far in the process, or whenever you've been ready to plant vegetables directly in your garden bed here, what have you done to prepare the soil?
Honestly?
Honestly, of course.
Not a whole lot, to be really honest.
Okay.
I think, like I said, I weeded and got some potting soil, and I think that's pretty much it.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's fine. That's actually a good place to start.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a lot of beginning gardeners don't take the time to prepare their soil,
mm-hmm.
and that is really, really important. It's very simple, actually. We're going to do it today in a very simple three-step process, which I see you've already started here on our first step.
Mm-hmm.
So first, we're going to dig up the soil.
Okay.
Then we're going to remove the weeds and the rocks, and then we're going to add some compost that will add nutrients to your soil and really nourish and help your plants grow.
All right.
Okay, so you ready to get your hands dirty?
Yes, I am ready.
Because we are going to get dirty today.
Okay.
Okay, let's get started.
All right.
Basically, what we want to do is dig down about a foot into the soil, loosen it up really well so that when we get the plants in here, the roots are going to be able to push down really easily and just form really nice, strong, stable, sturdy plants. And as we're doing that, we're going to work on step two because we're going to be getting lots of clumps of weeds down in here because you've got lots of weeds in here.
Yes, we do.
Doesn't look like you have a lot of rocks, which is really good. We'll be pulling out the weeds and just shaking out the soil so we can leave as much soil in the garden bed as possible.
All right.
All right, so let's get going.
All righty.
You got your shovel?
Yes.
I got my trusty pitchfork. This is one of my very favorite garden tools.
Weeding tool.
And I'm just going to go for it and show you how I like to do it.
Okay.
I just like to get my pitchfork down in here.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you got to jump on it.
Right.
So it goes down in there and just basically pull that up.
Okay.
And
getting them out.
Then, yeah, the weeds will be really easy to pull out at this
Perfect.
Point. Shake off
Yep.
the soil as much as possible. So we're going to go through here and just do that process in this entire garden bed. And
Okay.
we'll come back and talk about the compost. There's a lot of worms in here, and worms are going to be amazing for your garden bed because they break up the heavy clay soil that we have
uh-huh.
here in California,
right.
and they're just going to feed your garden nutrients. So this is a really good sign.
Okay.
I'm liking it, what I see already.
Very good.
I love being in the garden. This soil, I'm
mm-hmm.
so impressed with. It's nice and loose. It's almost like the person who lived here before you had a garden here. It sounds like he maybe did.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he did.
It looks great. So all we really need to do is add some compost. Now, to keep it simple, we're gonna buy our compost in bulk from a supplier that's just outside of town here. If you don't have access to that, people have the option to pick up some bag soil at the garden center.
All right.
So we're gonna head out with your son's truck, pick up a load, and come on back and add to the garden. Okay, so we're back with our load of compost. We're able to find this just outside of town. Look at this. Great stuff.
And so why are we adding this to our garden?
Well, compost is really good organic material. It'll help loosen up your soil as well. And it's really gonna add the nutrients that's gonna help your garden explode with growth and just be really productive for you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So we dumped about 4 or 5 wheelbarrow loads in here. That wasn't too bad.
Nope.
It's pretty quick.
Yep.
All we have to do now is just spread it out and then we'll work it into the soil, and that's really easy to do too.
Right. Now this is okay since it's higher than the edge.
Yeah, because it'll settle.
Okay.
Yeah, once we wet it down, it's gonna settle down.
All right.
Yeah. It's really easy to work into the soil. There's really not much to it.
Okay.
One little technique I like to do is use this little pitchfork. Just stab it into the soil and just twist like
okay.
that. And you just go all up and down the garden bed here. and it just works it right in.
Okay.
Because you want to work a couple inches of compost into your soil. And yeah, it's just gonna be perfect, this little plot. Get your soil nice and loosened up. And we're just about here. This is hard work, Mary Jo.
Yeah, I think I'm a little tired.
It's a good workout, huh?
Yeah, I'm gonna sleep well. My back's gonna be sore tomorrow. I need some, what is that, Advil? Yeah, Advil.
Okay, so we got our compost worked into our top few inches of soil, and little tip here, if you can, try not to stand on the soil as much as possible after it's been all raked out, because you don't want to compact it and just make it harder for the plants to get the roots down.
Right.
So if you were to summarize how to prepare your garden soil for spring, planting, what would you say?
All right.
Little test here.
Three tips how to get garden soil ready, right? Okay.
Yes.
So first we have to pull out our weeds and any rocks, loosen up our soil, turn it over. Two, and then three, add our compost and mix in top few soil and loosen up the soil that's there, right?
That's perfect. Us. The very last step before we add our plants is super exciting. That's going to be our next video. That is adding the drip irrigation.
All right.
That's going to be really cool. Before we get our plants in, we're going to have that added, soak the soil down, and you're ready to go with your garden.
All right.
Your $10 garden seedlings are ready to go in the ground. Can't wait. So if you haven't started your spring garden yet and you're looking for a place to buy seeds, get on over to migardener.com, pick up your $10 garden seed kit. You can use the coupon code CALICHEM10 to get a discount. All the information is in the description below. And if you're new here and like what you saw and are learning, I would really appreciate it if you subscribe, share with your friends, and jump in here with your spring garden. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.
Your seedlings. They're definitely getting big, starting to outgrow the grow light box. I wanted to go ahead and pull them out of here.
And how do you know when they're outgrowing the grow light box?
That's a really good question.